Stephanie from Mrs. D's Corner here. I'm coming to you from my at-home office to share with you how to use the 13-inch Scotch thermal laminator at home to laminate your file folders. So, I recently shared a link to grab the 13-inch laminator. It looks like this. I actually ordered a second one because the price was really, really cheap. So this is what it looks like in the box. It's 13 inches. I'm right side up to you guys and backwards to myself. Sorry, so I'm trying to get used to it. So this is my second one that I ordered. I have the first one that I paid for and I've had it for about a year. I paid over $60 on Amazon for this one. I just checked the link, which you can find the link above this video for the laminator, this laminator, and the pouches that I'm gonna share with you. Excuse me, I'm getting sick. The laminator is on sale right now, as of this video, this very moment, for $40, which is a really, really good deal. And the laminating pouches were about $25 and change. You get 100 pouches, the larger menu size laminating pouches, for $25, which is a really good price. I have been using these, and I think I paid $10 for 25. So I'm really excited to try the other brand out and see how they are, because you get a lot more bang for your buck with those. So I'm gonna try those out and let you guys know how I like them while we're doing this. So this is what we're gonna be talking about today. I'm gonna show you how to use it. I have the big laminator in front of me. I'm only gonna have one out tonight. And I have the little one here too. This is the little one. A lot of people ask what laminator I use at home. This is it, it's $20. It's from Walmart. I have three of them now, actually. One of them broke. It just wouldn't turn on, which is really rare. I have one that's like 6 years old and it's still working, but for 20 bucks, I can't beat it. So I'm not even mad about it. So $20, Walmart, I know Target has them too. They do carry the laminating pouches, the regular size laminating pouches, but that's not what we're talking about today. Today we're talking about this larger one, which I did order from Amazon. I haven't seen it anywhere in stores, but like I said, I checked right before this video and it was about $40. If you wanna grab it, the link is above the video here. So what I'm gonna show you how to do tonight, let me grab one, is how to laminate. That's not what I wanted. So what I'm pulling out here right now is I have laminated all of these file folders using my at-home laminator. And I get a lot of questions, do the file folders fit in here? Oh man, I didn't grab my file folders, they're in that. I'll have to grab them and disappear for a minute. But how do you laminate these at home? Do they really hold up? Is it worth getting one? Yes, 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 all the yeses. You need to have one of these laminators at your house. It will make your life so much easier. So let me pull one of these out. These are what I'm going to be prepping to show you guys how to do this, are my visual recipes. I'm gonna be prepping December's to get ready for the month, because December is like tomorrow, and that's crazy. So this one is from a previous month, and I laminated it at home. So you'll see that I've cut the tabs off the top and the other side, but you can see that it still shows that you have tabs. So if you wanted to write something here, you certainly could. And it fits perfectly within the pouch that I used. I got my file folders at Staples, as it says on the back. I put a cover on the front, I put everything inside. I'm gonna show you how to make this. So, I was really not gonna show you guys my, I'm wearing sweatpants, but I'm sorry. I have to grab my file folders really, really fast. I apologize. I should have been more prepared. Okay. Yes, my Jurassic Park sweatpants, it's okay. So I buy the file folders in a big pack. I got mine from Staples at the beginning of the school year, actually probably at the beginning of last school year. And I just buy them in all different colors because my classroom is color coded. So I'd like to have them in all different sorts of colors. So I'm thinking December is cold and snowy. So, well, not in Texas, but where I'm from, they are. So I'm gonna grab 5 blue file folders. I'm going to make December recipes blue. So I'm just gonna grab 5 regular file folders. Nothing special about these. You can use any file folder that you want. And I've already prepped and cut out, to save time, all of the pieces that I need to make that file folder that I showed you that was already done from a previous month. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use my, this is like a $20 Swingline paper cutter that I got on Amazon. If you would like the link, I can get it for you. It's locked. I am just going to cut this strip off here. I just line this up with a blade on the side, and I'm also going to cut this strip off here. It takes me super fast. And now this file folder will fit into the pouch that I'm going to show you. So all I did was cut maybe an inch and a half off. This is all that I cut off. Because if not, if you don't cut that off, it's not gonna fit into the pouch. If you're okay with it hanging over a little bit, that's completely okay. You do you. I'm crazily weird about that, and I like cutting it off. So you can see that it's still, one side is shorter than the other, so I can still write on here if I wanted to. I like having the staples on the outside, and I use stick glue. You can use your glue sponges if you want to on this. I save those for my kids. I don't use liquid glue only because when I'm prepping these, I don't let them dry. I stick them right through the laminator in the pouch. I'm sending my answer pieces through the little laminator. So I like to use this stick glue just to kind of hold the pieces onto the file folder before I stick it through the laminator. So that's what I'm gonna do really quick. So you want to have your glue, and I'm going to prep Buddy the Elf cookies. Oh my gosh, I shared a picture of these today on Instagram. They're so good, so, so delicious. You just take some chow mein, some white chocolate. What else is there? There's some marshmallows, some sprinkles, and some chocolate syrup. Oh my gosh, so delicious, so delicious. I am just sticking the cover on the front. Nothing is going on the back. So as you would normally prep any other file folder game, or whatever you're doing with your file folder, you are just going to prep it like normal. So I'm just gonna prep it like I would be throwing it through the school's laminator at home, the big one. Except I'm doing this at home with the 13-inch Scotch thermal laminator. Again, if you're just popping in, the link is above if you wanted to grab it. So I am using just regular stick glue. I have Elmer's glue. And I'm not putting a lot of glue on here. I'm just putting enough to get it to stick to the file folder to be able to send it through the laminator. That's all. And I'm really trying hard not to get any dog hair. It's like the real life struggle, guys. Because I have a wiener dog in a chocolate lab, there's hair everywhere all the time, no matter how many times I vacuum. So this is the front cover. These are what goes inside. This again is December visual recipes. The link is also above if you wanted to grab these and try them out. And the next thing is you're just gonna stick them in a pouch like you would anything else that you laminate. So at school, you don't put them in pouches, you just run it through the laminator. If you have the regular Scotch laminator, the regular size one, you stick it in a pouch and run it through. It's the same thing with this 13-inch laminator. Your pouches are just bigger. And the laminator looks a little bit different. So I'll try to pull the camera around and show you as I'm doing it, because it doesn't have that, like, the smaller ones have that lip to feed it through. The bigger ones are just flat, and there's an arrow to show you which way it goes. That way you don't put it in the wrong way or backwards and ruin the laminator, because you don't want to do that. So I'm just taking, this is the menu size laminating pouch. This is actually a Scotch laminating pouch. Let me throw it in one of these. So these are the pouches that I've linked above. They actually came yesterday in the mail. I ordered them on Black Friday, and they were $25. There's 100 menu size laminating pouches in here. So I'm gonna try them out. I've only ever used the Scotch brand. I'm pretty loyal to that brand because they never do me wrong, no matter how much they cost. I try to stock up when they're on sale, like they were on Black Friday. Did you guys grab any of those when they were on sale for $20? I grabbed five packs. I think I have enough pouches now to get me through like 2018. I'm just kidding. That won't even make it through like June. So I am just trying to line this up so that it fits nice. These ones, so surprisingly enough, you wouldn't have to cut. See, I've never used these, so I'm learning as I'm using these ones too. The Scotch ones, you have to cut the tabs off. These ones you don't. So the next one that I do, I just saw, there it is. You could actually leave the whole thing in there because there was enough space to totally leave that. So I didn't have to worry about lining it up perfectly. These are actually a little larger than the Scotch ones. So I really like this, actually. I'm going to trade Scotch in here for these menu-sized ones. That's awesome. All right, I'm wiping off dog hair as I'm doing this. So I have my larger laminator plugged in. I have it turned on already. It's the same thing as the smaller one. You're just going to plug it in. This is what it looks like, not in the box. There's a nice handle on it. I can't pull it too far because it's plugged into the wall over here. But it has a handle, which is nice because you can just grab it to stick it in. Here's the buttons. These pouches are 3 milliliters, so I push the 3 milliliter button. Sometimes I'll push the 5 if I want it to be a little hotter. It says on the box that it heats up in a minute, which is pretty cool. It's a lot faster than these little ones, in my opinion. I feel like I wait forever for them to get hot. If you can see, I can't see because your guys' names when you're watching are here, but there's an arrow right here. It's not on the other side. So unlike with the little one, you have the lip to kind of feed it down in. This doesn't have that. So you're gonna feed it in. You're not pulling these apart. So when you put it in a pouch, if you've never used laminating pouches before, they come like this. Do not pull them apart. This end here that is still like together, kind of seamed already, that's the side that goes into the laminator first. If you stick it in the other way, you're gonna kill your laminator. And that will be very, very sad. So actually, it's pointing this way towards you guys. So I'm gonna stick it in this way. And it's flat. So you lay it flat on a table. Can I show you? Yeah. So this is feeding out through here. Yeah, here it goes. Sorry guys, this is super high tech over here. It's just coming out like it would any other laminator, any laminator that you have at school. Except now your laminating file folder is in your house. It is a game changer for sure. And one more pouch. This is what I'm laminating over here on the little ones. These are the answer pieces for sequencing the recipe. What I like about the visual recipes that I have are they're real pictures. So as you're baking it, the kids can see like actual pictures. It's not clip art. So it's very, very great for visual learners. So actually, I now am going to not cut off this little tab. And I'm going to prep another one and stick it in a pouch and throw it through the laminator to see how it works. Because I am super impressed that these are a little bit larger than the Scotch ones. And the Scotch ones were more expensive. Again, I am just sticking just enough to make it stick to the pouch here or the file folder. So you're going to prep your file folder like you would any other file folder. Same as what you do at school if you're just popping in. Uh-oh. Sorry, you guys are sitting on a box and it was pushing out through the box. So here it came out. You can see the lip. I'm going to have to cut that off because it'll drive me nuts. But, and there's a laminated dog hair. I got it. But you can see it's laminated like normal. Now, when you do, same as if like at school, when you laminate a file folder and you go to stick it back, like folded, it's not going to stay folded like perfect. So I will do all of my file folders in one sitting, and then I'll take a binder clip and stick a binder clip at like 2 or 3 spots on the spines of all of them together to kind of get it to stay down, or I'll stick it under a big set of books and do it that way. It really helps. These are actual cooking recipes. So what I'm prepping for me right now to show you guys, these are recipes. The links above, they're December visual recipes. This one is for the Buddy the Elf cookies, which is what I just prepped the file folder here to get ready for my kids. I can't read. What's the biggest size for the laminator? The laminator it's 13 inches width. So anything up to 13 inches wide, you can laminate. Now, as far as like length, I don't know if this box tells me how long these are. They're 12 inches by 18 inches. So you could fit like an extra inch on the outside, but it won't be laminated. And you can go up to 18 inches long. I don't know how, if you could like finagle it somehow to make it longer. Or if there may be pouches out there that are actually longer than these ones, but these are perfect for, oh man, Staples is on the inside. These are perfect for using file folders. They're perfectly perfect. Let me stick, these ones are cocoa cups. Is that what it says? Cocoa cups. Oh, these are so cute. Oh, there's no picture. Okay, so I'm gonna use one of these bigger pouches. Again, you're gonna pull the sides apart that are not put together. Okay, do not pull it apart. And I didn't cut the tabs off of this one, so I'm gonna stick it in here. Excuse me, and turn this laminator off. I'm gonna stick it in here and see if it fits. Now with the Scotch pouches, you have to cut the tabs off. So if you're loyal to the brand like I was before this, then these ones are actually a little bigger and you don't have to cut the tabs off. But, so here we are. It's fit all the way to the end. You have the tiniest little bit of the top poking out. So if you're not gonna write on it, or if you really want them all to like be uniform, you don't have to cut them off. But if you want them to be uniform and perfect and all the same, then you can, that would bother you having the little lip hanging out, then you can cut them off and they'll fit. And then you'll just end up with this little lip here that I have, and you can just trim it. With the Scotch pouches, I don't trim them at all. I leave them in here, but these pouches are wider. So here, let's show you one of these. So this is S'more Mix. Move this back. And this was used with the Scotch pouch. Again, I cut off the tabs so that it would fit, and it fits perfectly inside the pouch. But there are ends of both of sides here that are sticking out just the tiniest bit. With these pouches, you don't have that. You actually have extra on the side, so you don't have to worry about it peeling, which is really nice. So I'm really excited about these pouches. I wish I had bought them sooner. And these are the pouches that I have linked above to Amazon for you. And the laminator is also linked above. So what else do I need to share with you about laminating? What other questions do you guys have? We're making those tomorrow. Oh, Charlotte, they're so good. They're so good. The Bunny the Elf cookies. You're gonna love them. Let me see if I can scroll really, really fast and see if you guys have any other questions. The big sheets. Shauna, the big sheets are linked right above this video. I buy them on Amazon. You could probably buy them like at Staples or something. I've never seen them at my Staples. I've not ever really looked for them though. $25, I think, is what these cost for like 100. So they're relatively cheap compared to the Scotch brand, which are a lot more expensive. Let's see, the biggest size for the laminator, I answered that. That's 13 inches. So this is the Scotch thermal laminator that I'm showing you. Again, this is the box that it comes in. It is a little bit heavier than the other one. You can do 5 milliliters and 3 milliliters. If you did want to research different size pouches, you can just search on Google or Amazon, just search menu size laminating pouches and see what other things come up. You're gonna find, if you search Amazon and search menu size laminating pouches, the ones that I linked above are gonna be the first ones that pop up. If you want the Scotch brand, just search Scotch. These ones are a different size. They're 11 by 17. So these ones that I've linked for you are 12 by 18. So they do give you that extra space to fit the whole, just about the whole. You have this little tiny bit here that doesn't fit. But if you have any other questions about the laminator, how to laminate things, again, it's really simple. It's just like doing it at school, except you're using pouches, but you're doing it at home. The laminator is really cheap right now. Actually, like I said, I linked it. It's above, and it was $40 right before I did this video. Price varies on Amazon day to day, so it might change. And when you're, if you're watching the replay, it might be a different price. So just check Amazon. I haven't seen it in stores anywhere, but I'm sure you can find it somewhere. I paid over $60 for mine on Amazon like a year ago. So $40 is actually a really, really good price. If you're looking for the regular size laminator, this is what I use. It's just the regular size laminator that all of them are. It's $20 at Walmart or Target. Target has them too. You can buy the regular size laminating pouches. They make smaller pouches. And you can send regular pouches through this one. It just doesn't have the lip to kind of help feed it through. So, but you can't send the bigger pouches through the smaller one. So if you're going to do file folders and you're looking, and if you're in the market for a laminator but want to do everything, just get the bigger one. You're not going to need the little one too, unless you want to have the little one too, but you don't need it. You could certainly do the smaller pouches through this as well. I know Scotch has smaller, like 5x7, and they have business card size ones and a whole bunch of different sizes. I've never tried any of the smaller ones, but I do know that they have them. Savannah says they have it at Walmart for a little cheaper. Okay, so check Walmart. My Walmart doesn't carry the larger laminator. They carry the smaller one. And I say $20, but I think it's like $17. My Walmart had it for like $17. So check. If you have any other questions or want to see anything, just send me a message. I'm happy to help. If you would like to see links for anything else that I've talked about but maybe not mentioned or not linked for you guys, just send me a message or leave a comment and I will link it back for you. I hope you have a great rest of your night. Have a great Friday tomorrow and a really relaxing weekend. Don't forget to think about you and recharge yourself. So I'll see you guys soon. Bye.